Hi, my name is Andy Ravenna, and I am a principal technical training consultant in the education department. Today, I'd like to show you how easy it is to explain a target variable in SAS VIA in just a couple of clicks. Basically, I want to show you how to use an automated explanation in SAS Visual Analytics. Being able to understand the relationship between a target and the explanatory variables is a key step towards building predictive models. Let's go ahead and get some high-level information about our data table. I'm going to go up to the Applications menu, and I'm going to select Discover Information Assets, which is going to bring me into SAS Information Catalog. You can see the name of my table is VS_bank. It's a data set which consists of observations taken from account holders from a large financial services firm. The accounts represent consumers of home equity lines of credit, automobile loans, and other short to medium term credit instruments. Since several of the continuous inputs are already skewed and have some missing values, I've cleaned up the data with both transformations as well as imputation, and that occurs before we perform our automated explanation. This is going to result in all of the continuous variables having an expression log_i_, and that is going to indicate those inputs which are already clean. Those are the inputs which I've already performed transformations and imputed missing values. And while there is a lot of column information here on this table, we're really just going to focus in on one item for now, which is B_target. And really, that's a variable that reflects whether an account is going to contract for at least one product during the campaign season. You can see that it has a total of two distinct levels or values. And if we look over here, we can see that B_target, or really the name of the variable is target binary new product. That's what we'll see when we get into visual analytics, has values of zeros and ones. The easiest way to think about this is that a one is going to indicate that an account or a customer made a purchase, and a zero is going to indicate that they did not make a purchase or they are a non-purchaser. Now, we can also see that the data set contains over 1 million rows and 54 columns. We are not going to use all of those columns when we get into visual analytics, and we'll talk about why that is when we get there. There is a whole bunch of other columns that have information, for example, demographic information, the account activity level, the customer value level, and there's even a whole bunch of continuous variables that have indications of purchase behavior. Since we want to take advantage of the automated explanation, I'm first going to need to open up this table in SAS Visual Analytics. And so that's easy to do. I go over to Actions and say, I am ready to explore and visualize this particular table. Now we can see that I've got a list of all of these inputs, but remember, we don't want to use them all, and this is why. The way the automated explanation works is it is going to use all of the inputs or variables that it sees here as part of the explanation. Well, we have a total of like 58 variables. That's a whole bunch of variables. We don't need all of those. It would make the explanation too complex. So we're just going to narrow our focus down to 16. So let me show you how we can basically filter out or hide those variables. Account ID is not one of the variables that we want to use. It's not going to be helpful in terms of explanation. So what we're going to do is we're going to select, let's hide it. Then we've got some demographic variables. I'm going to select those all the way down until I get to the first variable that I want to use, which is this log I variable. I'm going to do a shift click just before it, and then I can do a right click and hide all of those variables. So now we can see I've got my categorical variables, I have my log I. Remember, log I underscore is an indication that these are my clean variables. So I really don't need any other variables except my target variable. So let's go ahead and hide the rest of these. So here are the original dirty variables. Let's select this one and scroll down and do a shift click and hide these. And then I've also got two target variables that I don't need. So let's go ahead and hide those as well. Great, we're now down to the 16 variables that I need for my automated explanation. But before we get to that, we have one last thing to do. And that is, it looks like target binary new product is in my list of interval variables. In other words, the visual analytics interface believes, because it's made out of zeros and ones, that it's actually a continuous variable. But since we want this to be our target variable, it needs to be a categorical variable. So I'm going to do a right mouse button click and simply say, hey, convert that variable into a category. And now we can see that it is a categorical variable with a cardinality of 2, and we're ready to go with our automated explanation. The automated explanation reveals to us the most important underlying features of our target variable. Remember, in this example, I'm trying to understand whether an account is going to make a purchase or not. Let's easily create an explanation in a report with just one click. I'm going to do a right mouse button click on my target variable and say that I would like to explain it on the current page. And now it is building that automated explanation for me. You can see in this resulting report that my target variable has an 80% chance or predicted probability of being a zero. So what does that mean? That means the majority of my customers are non-purchasers. Well, let's be honest. If I'm trying to understand my customers, I'm probably going to be more interested in the purchasers than the non-purchasers. So let's simply update this chart by coming over and clicking on the 1 instead of the 0. And now you can see that the remaining portion of this report is going to explain to us what's going on with the 20% of the data that are in fact purchasers. Let's continue our investigation of the automated explanation by looking at the remainder of the summary bar along the top. So in addition to giving me a breakdown of my target variable, you can also see here that it says the three most related factors are the count purchased over the past 3 years, the average sales over the lifetime, and the average sales over the past 3 years in direct response to a promotion. If you think about it in the real world, it would make sense that these particular inputs or explanatory variables would have a very large effect on whether or not a customer was going to make a purchase or not. What's also kind of fascinating is there's already another chart available to me that says what factors are most related to the target binary new product, which is our target variable. And you can see that those three inputs that were described in the summary bar are at the top of this chart, along in descending order of importance with the remaining explanatory variables. Also notice that the top bar, which is the count purchased over the past 3 years, is already selected. It might be interesting to ask the question, how is this one particular input related to our target variable? Well, guess what? There is also another chart that's available to help us understand that. So we can see what is the relationship between the target binary new product and the count purchased over the past 3 years. The information here tells me that the average count purchased over the past 3 years is about 1.6. So right in there is about the average. But remember, I actually transformed this data. So if we were to back transform, it turns out that in reality, our customers purchased about 5 products on average. Maybe we're interested in how the target that we have interacts or is related to a categorical variable. For example, maybe the account activity level. Well, we can come over to our other plot and scroll down and find that categorical variable that's related to the account activity level and select it. And you can see that is going to then update the relationship chart. What is this chart telling me? Well, this is not unexpected. It looks like that customers that have an account activity level of X has the majority of the purchasers in it. So this particular categorical variable has a total of 3 levels describing our customers' account activity. The X level are the highest active accounts. Y are medium and Z are low. And so this chart does make sense. The data that we see related to this chart actually falls in line with what we would expect. I'd like to show you one more option that's available to us with our automated explanation. And that's an option that's going to show us our most likely and least likely groups of purchasers. Now, since we're probably most interested in our most related factor, before I turn that option on, I'm going to return over here to the factors chart, and I'm going to reselect our top factor, which is the count purchased over the past 3 years. Then, what I'm going to do is come over into the options, and we're going to scroll down under the general displayed visuals. You can see there's an option here for high and low groups. Now, since we're interested in that and we've already looked at the other charts, I'm going to go ahead and turn the other ones off so that we have the maximum amount of real estate to investigate this new chart that we're interested in. So I'm going to turn that on. I'm going to turn off factors, characteristics, relationships, and relationship descriptions. And then we'll close up my options pane. By default, this chart is going to show me the top 3 groups that have the highest predicted probability of making a purchase. You'll notice there's a high tab and a low tab. Let's just focus in on the high tab since we're probably most interested in those customers that are most likely to make a purchase. And here the highest predicted probability is almost 80%. It tells us that if the count purchased over the past 3 years is greater than or equal to 1.6, and the months since the last purchase is less than 2.6, then we have an 80% predicted probability of making a purchase. In case you're curious, there's actually a decision tree running in the background to give us that information. Now that we've done a bit of data exploration, let's quickly and easily see how we can build a predictive model. I'm going to go to the upper right-hand corner object menu and say I would like to change this automated explanation into a logistic regression. I am still astounded at how easy it is to create models in SAS via. Just a couple of clicks and I already built a predictive model. Being able to quickly explore your data and efficiently build models are key and important skills to being a data scientist. Let's go ahead and take just a real quick look at this logistic regression. You can see along the top here in the summary bar that we are modeling our purchasers in this logistic regression. And there's a KS statistic of about 0.546. We can use that statistic to compare against other models because higher KS values are better. We can also see how many observations were used to build this model. Now, in terms of the rest of these pieces of output, I think it'll be easier to go over to our options and give us just a little bit more real estate. So I'm going to scroll down underneath my display options and change the plot layout from fit to stack. And that's going to take each piece of output and put it on a separate tab. When we look at the fit summary panel, this tells us which of our inputs are significant to the logistic regression model. And remember, we have a total of 16 inputs. And it looks like all but one of them are significant at the 5% level. So if we were to end up doing some sort of variable selection, we might want to leave this last input out of our model because it doesn't appear to be significant. We also have an odds ratio plot. We can see over here, this is the odds ratio for the count purchased over the past 3 years, and it's almost at 6. So what's very interesting about odds ratio is they tell us how more likely one group is to another in terms of making a purchase. So we might be interested in taking a look at the rest of these as well. My residual plot doesn't show any outliers or unusual values, so that's good. And then finally, when we take a look at our assessment, you can see that this model was able to correctly identify just over 80,000 purchasers as purchasers. So my model correctly identified them. And then in terms of the non-purchasers, we were able to identify over 800,000 of those correctly. Now that you've seen how easy it is to create automated explanations, I hope you'll try using them. If you want to know more, make sure you click on the links and the description. If you like this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And for more great videos, don't forget to subscribe to the SAS Users YouTube channel. Never stop learning.